So here we are at the trailhead. Mt Baldy summit, 6 miles. It was about 13-minute hike up this road. Goes through some neighborhoods where you could see a few of my homes. We got a lot of stream water. And I had to return the Alps Mountaineering Shasta 4200 backpack. It was just too uncomfortable. And their customer service wasn't very good. So I'm trying out this cheap $50 backpack. And I'm not sure if it's going to be any more comfortable. If not, I'm going to have to try a different one until I find a backpack that's comfortable. Hey, there goes my helicopter. That's the easy way up to the top of the mountain. So we took a little break here. And that's the first spot of some leftover snow here on the way to the peak, 7,800 feet. Now this backpack, Grizzly Peak, this is the internal frame, and they didn't put any padding right here. I guess they're supposed to be able to adjust it a little bit there, so maybe that's why they didn't put any. That's pretty stupid, because that hurts. So I may have to get a different backpack. Oh boy. I got two more other backpacks I might try. Both of those are uncomfortable. I may have to rethink this. So we came up to our first sheer drop here. So we gotta watch your footing up here. So here we're on the west face of the mountain range that goes up to Mt Baldy. We got some really steep places over here. That ridge over there, you could probably actually climb up, starting way down there in the canyon. Looks like there's a road. Maybe the road that I came up, or it may be San Gabriel Canyon Road, goes down to East Fork. Anyway, Iron Mountain is, I think that's over there, and then you can also then go down pretty hairy, and then come up to Mount Wilson. But look at how steep this thing is. Man, it's not for the faint at heart up here. So we made it to the Narrows. It's a little narrow part there with steep drop-offs. So I found a little spot to take a break before I go across the Narrows. I need to put on my micro spikes. I got my snow boots on. Tried to tape a little bit at the top with these stretchy running pants that I have so that snow won't go inside my boot. Now, sometimes there's wind, so I need to try to time the crossing of the Narrows when there's no wind just to be a little safer. Now, I don't have any fear because I don't fear anything. But I wonder where that ultra chick is who was scared of the Mount Wilson trail and had to turn back. I'd love to see her do this, cross the Narrows, carrying a 40-pound backpack. How about 45? That's what I'm carrying today. 45 pounds. Look at this thing, man. Load it up. So, not sure how good a video position this is going to be, but we are at the Narrows, and there you can see down. Boy, I'm pretty winded. It's tiring. So we're on the approach to Mt Baldy. You can see the icy snow, some footprints, and there goes a nice view of the scenery that we've got. So I had to do a little bear crawl to get up this little ledge here, because I wanted to check out the view. I think it's got these really cool rocks. Could maybe sit up there, read a book. Hope you don't get blown off by the wind. And there, we've got some of the nice ridges. Now, that's probably Iron Mountain over there. So these are lower peaks. It's pretty windy right here. There are three hikers. They're on their way back from the summit. They all got ice axes and crampons. Well, it's a little windy to be climbing up this rock, but the view is so great, I decided to do it. Look at this view. This is great. Of this rock. So far so good. It's 3:20. I started maybe at 7:40, so it's been taking me a long time to get up here. I'm taking a lot of breaks, and I put on my micro spikes and ice axe since going through the narrows. This is really pretty. Boy, look at how pretty it is up here. So I left the rock. My camera fell down when I was going down the rock, so I had to go and fetch it. That was kind of fun. But here we got a steep face. So I'm just going along this little ridge here to get a better view of Iron Mountain. And maybe I won't film it, but kind of neat up here. Gotta be careful, don't go too close to the edges. Don't want to get blown off the edge. But it's pretty nice. There's melted snow, so there's a clear path to walk here. So there it looks like West Baldy. And there you can see the ridge. It's pretty steep. Right there, and really steep ridges over there too, Iron Mountain, and there's a lot of bushwhacking. If you go this way, a lot of bushwhacking to get to that hill, but this looks like an easier approach. Can't see how steep it is from there, but you can take a look on the map. But that looks really hairy going that way. Really steep right around there. I don't know if I would want to do that. But last week I was talking with this guy who said that he went to Iron Mountain, then to Baldy. So I just took a look at it and I don't know. That looks pretty sketchy. So I'm on the final little climb to Mt Baldy. There's West Baldy. And the final last part. Thank you. close. Devil's backbone. There doesn't seem to be much snow, so I think it's going to be okay. Hopefully. I talked to the Senate two guys, and they said the 10th of the trail is there. So we're taking the Devil's backbone back to the lodge, and then we're going to go hike it to the campground on the road. Ski hut's over there, over that hill. Not too far, maybe half a mile, but that's too steep and too slippery, so I'm not going to be going that way. It was really windy up there. My battery ran out, so I wasn't able to finish my little video clip. But the wind has died down over here because it got protection from the hill. The wind is going in this direction, which is unusual. But you know, sometimes the wind shifts over here. Looks like it's pretty good. I was going to cook something up on the top of the stove. Test the stove out. Something to eat. Pretty hungry now. So we're on the way back to the lodge, or to the lodge. Ski lifts. Look at how steep this is. Over here there's no snow. So this part is a little sketchy. Look at how steep it is. Now when there's ice and snow around here, it's really dangerous. Right now it's kind of okay. Just gotta be careful. Every step. Thank you. pretty much past the sketchy park. A little bit left, but I'm gonna turn the video off
the camera.
So tell us, what's your best? What's your most famous hike?
Me?
Yeah.
Greg, you've done the PCT, haven't you?
I don't have any famous hikes.
Did you do the PCT?
No. I'm a.
Oh, you used to live here though, right?
I used to live in Mt Baldy.
What was it like to live here?
It was great.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, crackheads. Crystal meth, skiing.
Were you renting or you had
no,
your?
No, I owned the cabin.
Oh, why'd you sell it?
Because I had to work more.
Oh darn, you had to work. Yeah. What a bummer.
Yeah. The work extends.
All right, man.
This is Mt Baldy. This is Mt Baldy.
Hey, you got a cute girl going
That's
with you today.
Sam, my new friend.
Yeah. So.
Sam's never hiked on Mt Baldy before. So
oh well,
gonna,
well you're gonna be a good guide. So.
Today.
All right.
She's gonna crush.
It's all right. Have a good one.
We're going to go 10,064 feet today.
There you go. So it maybe got to about 39 last night. I didn't put up the tent because I got to camp about 9:30. And it was warm enough with this sleeping bag. As long as I zipped things up, it was kind of uncomfortable. I was on an incline to sleep. And look at all this gear I have. And it's about 45 pounds of gear. And I tried cooking dinner last night and breakfast in the morning. This automatic ignition, the piezo ignition, didn't work. I had to start it with a flint, but other than that everything was okay. I was able to fill up water at the stream and gonna get started pretty soon. So here are the waterfalls. Look at all the nice water. We've got a couple of ultra runners here.
Woo-hoo.
They're gonna go up to Mt Baldy. This guy went up to Baldy, and this is the guy who was behind me when I lost my crampon. He's still got his mountaineering boots.
Still got him on.
He's like serious mountaineer here.
Serious stuff.
So she's a serious runner. She does half marathons. And what, this is his rugby coach.
I wish.
All right.
Take care. You got one.
Hey, so we're here at the ski hut. I thought these two ultra runners were going to turn back and go back to their car, but they toughed it out. They're going to go to the summit.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Easy money.
And this guy's going to do the PCT next week.
All right.
The whole thing?
Woo!
All right.
I'm doing the whole thing.
And here she is, our sponsor. She's back. And a couple of people here. Look at this guy. He's sliding down. Look at that. Hey. So she's climbing up. Look at this. Making it look easy.
Yeah, right.
All right, good job.
Are you training for like PCT or something? Or
even next Sunday.
Right on.
Well,
for the whole thing. Keep training, baby.
The whole thing, man.
So you guys made it to the summit?
Yeah, we made it to the summit.
How was it?
Awesome.
Beautiful.
You guys like it?
It's about 3 feet of snow up there.
Oh, I remember you guys from the morning. It's the funky pants.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
The funk here.
Okay, good. And we got over here the army girl.
Hello.
You better not mess with her. She's going to kick your butt. So here we got a couple of more mountaineers coming down from the summit.
Sam.
And look at this guy's serious ice axe, carbon fiber. Man.
The ultimate ice axe.
Oh. That's right. The ultimate ice axe.
Today is a service day. Led a group up. PCT guy working on his arrest technique.
Yeah.
Up at the top, we did some glissading. We did some arresting.
There you go.
And
what's the website? How can they reach you?
Yeah, SoCalHiker.net.
There you go. You can hire him. He'll teach you how to use an ice axe.
You can't hire me. All you can do is party with me.
Oh, there you go.
He's not
for hire.
There's no paperwork.
Hey,
you're like the PCT guru, right?
No, I'm a Baldy guy.
Hey, this guy's going to do the PCT next week.
Oh, right on.
Nice.
You're going to be on the PCT?
Here we got a radio. It's, what brand is it?
It's a Yaesu VX8.
And he says he can get good reception to the repeaters with it.
Yeah.
Do you have to program it yourself?
You have to program it. Either software you can program it with.
All right.
I'd recommend it.
Yeah. Costly? How much about is it?
They're probably $300.
Wow, $300.
Yeah, I don't know. I bought a brand new.
But you can call and from Mt Baldy, no problem.
Yep.
Yeah. Right.
People send themselves
So here we're at the summit.
Or 60 boxes.
San Antonio, Mt Baldy, 10,064 feet.
And then the other strategy is to...
He made it up to the summit.
Send nothing.
She made it up to the summit.
And just try to buy it.
This guy made it up to the summit.
And then I'm sending 11 boxes because I got...
So, how is the summit? What do you think, huh? There you go. From the Army veteran. It's fucking amazing. Oh, I should have beeped that out. Oh, well.
Sorry.
Hi, back up on top of Mt Baldy. It's a hard thing to do, a lot of pain issues, but I made it. Better sitting on the couch.
This guy made it, he had meningitis, right?
Yes, bacterial meningitis.
Almost died?
Almost died, half hour dying.
And that's no excuse for anybody else. You're get off your great. Butt and get up to Baldy.
That's right, get up off your ass and get on top of Mt Baldy or any one of these great peaks here.
There Woo! You go, all right. Yeah. Sometimes my micro spikes slide down to the heel. That's not good. So here we got some of the best cooks ever at the ski hut.
Especially him.
So best definitely come over here and visit.
Why not toilet hiking and enjoy? Why not even hiking?
Here he is, the famous Mt Baldy hiker.
Thank you.
He's going up.
Thank you.
Be careful.
You're too much young.
Yeah, that's true.
You're 35, 45.
I'm pretty young.